Hey, welcome back to the cave. Weapons Cave, this is your host, the Weapon X Jamie, also known as Jamie Waring. Hello everybody out there in YouTube land. Welcome back to the cave. This is another episode here of the Weapons Cave, and I'm just going to be a short little update. I'll do my very best to make this a short update. I know I do one heck of a job of rambling, and I try to keep this video short, but hey, I love to talk, but I'll do my very best to keep this bad boy under 10 minutes. I'll do my very best. This is just another update of what I've got going on here in the cave, basically my bench. As far as the Dave Mustang tribute, 2010 Dave Parker tribute build, the Camaro, and also the 1968 El Camino rebuild. And we also have an addition. But enough of that talk. Let me go ahead and just get in here real quick and let you guys see what's going on. I'll be right back. Do a little bit of refocusing. Thank you. Hey. Welcome back, people. Thanks for pausing here for the quick pause. But one thing I forgot to mention, I am finished with the 2010 Dave Parker tribute build. Finally finished. Finished her up. I think it's been about maybe 3 days now. I got her all shined up and looking sexy. I'm just gonna do a quick little pan, just to show the final results here. I have to admit, I used a polished Meguiar's Plastics, and I have to say I am pretty darn happy with the results. She's looking pretty darn good. I mean, she's nice and shiny and sleek and sexy, has that wet look, looks like brand new money. Let me go ahead and spin her around here for you guys right quick. I'm gonna be extremely careful because I do my very best not to handle her, not to touch her, so by the time she gets to Dave Parker, she'll still be nice and gorgeous for the guy. But oh yeah, I'm really, really happy with the results here. Came out pretty good. Of course, this is about probably, I have to say, maybe 5 coats of Krylon clear went on her. Now the hood is done in Rust-Oleum clear. I had to do that because I ran out of the Krylon by the time I got finished. But once I did that, we took the Meguiar's Plastics and we just went to town. I mean, we put her on there and buffed. And what I used at first, if I'm not mistaken, I was using some, I went to Walmart and purchased some flannel. I got a yard for a dollar of flannel at a Walmart, and just, you know, took it piece by piece and just did follow directions and just went to work. They came, but it did also, no, matter of fact, no, I lied, it didn't, the plastics came like that. But the other day, well, I'm just gonna go ahead and finish showing this, right, you know, one more time, let you guys see her, because I have to be honest, this is my first time actually polishing. And I'm pretty darn happy with the results. No, I did not. I put the decals on last, and I did not want to mess with another coat of clear or anything like that. So I just put the decals on and left it. Even though it's the decals are dull and they're not shiny, I'm not mad about it. I'm pretty happy about it. I'm not upset, not one single bit. Look at that, the camera can focus, do a little bit of autofocus, and check that out, Loppy John Brown. Look at that, I figured it out, just like that, that's awesome. But, yeah, I didn't want to mess with another coat, because, I mean, she was pretty darn perfect the way she was, and I just wanted to leave it at that. So I'm going to go ahead and get her out of the way. Hold on, let me put the camera down here for a second, and we will continue with the update. And also, with the With the El Camino, I had to do a redo on this. Lord, that light looks kind of weird, doesn't it? I think I'll back this up here a little bit. Well, I'll be John Brown. It does refocus. Look at that. Ha! The camera does refocus and focuses in. I'll be John Brown. Although this camera doesn't do that. Well, what do you know? Anyway, well, where we're at with the El Camino. I did have the top mask, but I left the masking on too long. Yes, I'm still learning. And the adhesive stayed on the roof here, the rag top here. So I had to get some alcohol. Thanks, Chris, dude, you're awesome, bro. I was instructed to get some alcohol and just wipe her down, get the adhesive off, wipe it down clear. So I just went ahead and brush paint the flat black back over it, and just start the process over. But it's okay though. I mean, we're just probably gonna do one more coat of dry brush. I'm a little bit excited because I got some more stuff I want to tell you guys. I'm just gonna do one more coat of dry brushing flat black. Then after that I'm gonna go ahead and bar metal foil the trim, and that's one thing I'm excited about because I've only really done it once before, but it really wasn't on an actual serious build, but not like this right here. And I'm just really excited about it because I get to actually use my bar metal foil on the trim. And I'm pretty excited about it. And I'm thinking I'm going to use bar metal. I don't know. I may use the HVAC tape, or I just may use the bar metal foil. I'm not quite sure yet. But also, I'll just show you guys also what I started. I also started the 1970 Mark I Mustang. This is also a rebuild. It was already done, but I took her down and figured, oh, you know what, I'm going to do her again and put some more emphasis in things that I've learned as far as dealing with modeling and just, you know, put it together dealing with this build. And I went ahead and just sanded it down. Look at that little imperfection. I went ahead and sanded her down already and did one coat of, I went ahead and primed her already and did, one go over of some wet sanding, but I'm gonna do it again. I think I went from about maybe probably 600 sandpaper to 3000 and just got it nice and smooth. But I'm gonna go, of course, I'm gonna probably do about two more coats of primer. But one thing I'm also excited about, besides, you know, the other stuff that I'm gonna, you know, also do with the build, I went ahead and bar metal foiled. All right, you guys can't see it. You know what? I'm gonna pause right back and be right back. So I want you guys to see this. Yeah, but I'm just gonna pause right quick and refocus because I want you guys to see something. Be right back. All right, welcome back once again. I went ahead and just bar metal foiled the Mustang emblem here, and the tail lights here in the back, caution lights here in the back. Even though it's a rebuild, they were a little worn, but I did a little bit of engraving. And because I've heard that you could put bar metal foil down on it after, I think if I'm not mistaken, after primer on the emblems or whatever, and you can go over it with the primer, and then once again go over it with the base and wet sand it off. I was also told that I was told once again, thanks Chris, you can just get a toothpick, put some thinner on it, let it soak in some thinner and whatever you're using, I guess lacquer or enamel. And just let it soak up the toothpick and just scrub it out that way. So I'm pretty excited about that because I cannot wait to see the outcome. Right now, I am like stoked beyond compare right now. I know for some people these are simple things, but for me these are new things that I'm trying, and I'm really looking forward to seeing how it comes out. I really, really am. But we're gonna go ahead and leave the front ones. You know, we're not gonna mess with the front ones because they're a little bit more engraved, and we've, you know, this bad boy's been sanding a good many times, so we're just gonna kind of leave it as is. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and refocus, and I'll be right back. Thanks for holding. All right, back one more time. Thanks again for holding. Something else that I'm really, really, really stoked about. I ordered some Novus polishing from Amazon the other day, and it came in here yesterday. And once again, I'm stoked. I'm excited because I cannot wait to see how this bad boy is gonna come out on that Mark One there. It's gonna come out pretty good. I went ahead and did on the El Camino. I used the plastics again, Meguiar's plastics on the hood here of the El Camino, and it came out pretty good. I can't lie. I'm probably gonna do it. Do another coat of it, of course. You know, to give it, you know, a really, really good shine. But what I went ahead and did, now remember, this is the original, the first Dave Mustang tribute build, 1998 Corvette. I went ahead and took the hood, and I used the Novus treatment. Yes, I used 3, 2, and 1. I know some people are like, you know, you don't use 3. But this bad boy had a good bit of scratches in it. So at first I used 1 to clean her off. Then I used 2 to think, well, okay, you know, I'll just do that and that'll be fine. But I said, you know what, wait a minute, these scratches in this bad boy is kind of deep. So I went ahead and used 3. I used 3, then I went to 2, then I went back to 2, and this sucker came out gleaming, as you can see. Then after that, my buddy, once again, Chris, thanks, Chris, he said to go ahead and throw some wax on that bad boy to seal her in. So I went ahead and grabbed my turtle wax, you know, super hard shell wax, you know, car wax or whatever, and I waxed it in, and my God, my God, my God, dude, this sucker is just... Bling! This sucker is gleaming, and I'm stoked right now. I can't say it anymore. I'm stoked. I'm stoked. I'm stoked. I'm stoked. Squirrel. Anyway, but yeah, the Novus is just amazing. It's amazing because, of course, we all know it's a finer grit of polish. So yeah, it does its job. But anyway. We're stoked about that. That's what we have going on. I have all my pieces house set out here and primed for the 1970 Mark One Mustang here, and we're gonna be getting ready to get this all done up. We already have the hood and the front and the back bumper already wet sanded. Gonna get ready to sand these bad boys here probably tomorrow and get her going. I went ahead and dewired that engine that I did have wired, but it was kind of a shoddy job. So I went ahead, what I did, I went ahead and started playing around with some wires and saw that some people actually, I saw this guy, who was it? Oh God, not Model Car Nut. Oh, what's his name? Ah, God, I cannot remember your name, dude. I am so sorry. He did a tutorial or a clinic, or whatever everybody wants to call it, on doing your own custom, your own boot wires. So I went ahead and tried to do it my darn self, and as you can see, I actually pulled it off. So I'm going to be using Radio Shack's wrapping wire here, and use these insulated wires here, and I'm going to be doing my boot wires there on my on my valve covers. I tried to actually do it on the distributor, but the insulated wires is a little too... It fought me a good bit. And at the same time, I'm just going to take my time and just, you know, do one thing at a time because I'm learning as I go. As you can see, there's a distributor right there. And I'm just going to use the boot wires there on the valve covers and not the distributor. But, you know, it's all good. I'm pretty stoked about it. Pretty hyped about it. Can't wait to get all this accomplished. And I'm just appreciating the process and just appreciating... You know, everybody that's helping me and giving me feedback and, you know, all this good stuff like that. But I'm just going to fade back here. I'm not going to refocus just so I can ramble. This is just a quick shout out to everybody once again last week who did the Modelers Hangout. Thank you for everybody once again who came, who hung out, who participated. And thanks, Atomic Dog 32, dude. You did an amazing job keeping up with the comments. Thank you. Top Revision, dude, we will get you in there this weekend, I promise you. Hopefully you went and gone and got that web camera, because you're going to need it, pal. But if you don't, dude, it's cool. It's cool. I mean, we just chat. We just do our thing. But thanks to everybody, you know, who was commenting. Juan, thanks for, Juan, thanks for joining us, bro. Everybody who joined, everybody who chatted, everybody who commented, everybody who watched. Just thank you, you know, one and all. Thanks to everybody who I am subbed to. Thanks everybody who subbed to me. I appreciate it. But yes, once again, we will be doing the same thing this week. The only change that we will have, 5 o'clock, yes, Modelers Corner will be pumping live again this Saturday, 5 o'clock p.m. East Coast time. This week, our special guest will be, yes again, Google's Plus, very, and YouTube, and Facebook's very own Robert Daws. That's right, Robert Daws, a.k.a. utterly known as Spike, will be our guest today. He's one of the members of the old guard. He's been doing this for a long, long time. He's one of the old boys. You know what I mean? One of the guys that has a lot of experience, a lot of information, and plenty well-to-do tips and how-to dealing with styrene. So I'm looking forward. I'm stoked. I'm excited. We got Robert, Spike, Daws coming in to the Weapons Cave at the Weapons Corner this Saturday at 5 o'clock. So just be there. Hope everybody, I appreciate everybody who will come, who will watch in advance. Now, as far as the Modelers Hangout concern, Big Boss Jim and once again Spike, they are bringing it back, the Styrene Chat, back to Google's Hangout, Google Plus. So they'll be doing theirs at 6 o'clock. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to just alternate around those guys because they've been here first. Then me, myself, personally, they're older, they've been here, so obviously, of course, they have seniority. And thank you, Spike, for just saying, you know, getting with me and asking me, you know, taking me into consideration, what did I want to do? And I just said, nah, dude, you know, whatever you want to do, you've been here first, you've got seniority, I'll work around you guys' schedule. So, once again, Styrene Chat is back with Big Boss Jim and Spike. So be there to watch that as well. Google Plus, of course, YouTube as well. Hangout live, hangout on air. Styrene Chat and Modelers Hangout will be right after that. Because if I'm not mistaken, they'll be doing Styrene Chat for 2 hours, 6 to 8, and I'll just pump up right behind them at around 8 o'clock or 8:05. So yes, we're still doing it, but we're just doing some alternating, just some moving around for other fellow model builders. That's also doing some things too, and getting the word back out there. So thanks for stopping by. Thanks for coming by the cave. Thanks for watching. If you like what you see, like what you heard, hit the big old like button if you want to. Or hit the dislike button. Here, we're just here about showing styrene. Appreciate all the comments in advance. Once again, see you guys at the show. Deuce line, say two times. Be good. Later.